bad boy of erotica. Retail Audio Sample. Chapter 1. I had just finished making my early morning rounds in the computer center, and I was headed back to my office when one of my clients asked me for some assistance with the program that she was developing. I pulled a chair up next to her desk and deftly stuck my hand under her miniskirt, rubbing on her clit. As far as I was concerned, life didn't get any better than this. I was in my junior year as a computer-based information systems major at Howard University, and I was working as a technical assistant for the university's computer center. I worked there between class breaks and made up the majority of my hours on the graveyard shift between midnight and 7 a.m. I loved my job because it enabled me to get my hustle on, a hustle that made me more money than I made as a TA, and also had the side benefit of providing me with various sexual favors. I soon discovered working on the graveyard shift that the people using the lab during those times were primarily made up of the technically challenged. People cheating their way through computer-based majors and individuals who needed to take one or more programming classes as an elective and couldn't hang. These people would barter, pay, and fuck the TA such as myself to do their programs for them. Those of you reading this story that know me are probably shocked and appalled right now. Euphdis, you're probably saying to yourself. I can't believe you took advantage of the desperate. I sure as hell did. Any other questions? Which brings me back to the client that I mentioned earlier. As I rubbed her clit, I scrolled through her program. She was in my major and was in dire need of changing it, but had not yet faced reality. She was one of my regular customers, and I had written the bulk of her program for her earlier that day. I told her to change the variable names and complete the last 30 lines of code needed herself so that our professor would not be able to tell that she had not written it. As I reviewed her code, I let her know that she could have completed the assignment with less statements than she used, but it was good enough for what Mr. Burnham, the professor of the course, wanted. I squeezed her pussy in my hand. Baby, bring this to me on Thursday versus Wednesday this week. I have a rough assignment to finish in Op Systems, and it's due Thursday morning. I'll probably be here all night on Wednesday, I whispered to her. No problem, Euphdis. Same time, she whispered back. Yeah, same time, baby. I got up with no one the wiser, or so I thought, and headed to the office that I shared with the other technical assistants. Excuse me, a female voice boomed out in the lab directed at me. Can I get some help? I know I don't have a miniskirt on. I apologize. I didn't know that that was a requirement to get some assistance down here, she said very sarcastically. Most of the people in that part of the lab looked up from their monitors to see what was going on. I turned to see a chocolate sister who had some of the biggest cheeks that I had ever seen on a woman. I just wanted to run up and pinch them. She was beat up from the floor up. It was a little after 3 a.m., and from the looks of her, hair pulled back, no makeup, baggy jeans, worn tennis shoes, and wrinkled t-shirt, it was obvious that she had been in the computer center for a while, struggling to get her program done. As I looked at her staring at me with an upset look on her face, I realized that I had seen her before. She had distracted the hell out of me my freshman year in intro to the School of Business. She would wear the shortest miniskirts during those hot summer days, and she could never sit still. She had legs that rivaled Tina Turner, and she would constantly cross them back and forth. I sat above her in the auditory-style classroom, and every time she moved those big legs, my eyes locked on her. It was obvious that her computer class was kicking her ass because she was a far cry away from that sexy woman who didn't have a hair out of place and dress fly as hell. End of audio sample. This concludes the audiobook sample of Grass, Ass, or Cash. No one rides for free. If you enjoyed this excerpt, hit the link on the profile. If you'd rather have the ebook, softcover, or hardcover versus the audiobook, then check out my book Off the Chain, which this story is a short story from that book.